"Ozma ordered the boy's arrest," said Dorothy, "and of course she knew what she was doing. But if you can prove Ojo is innocent, they will set him free at once."
"They'll have to prove him guilty, won't they?" asked Scraps.
"I suppose so."
"Well, they can't do that," declared the Patchwork Girl.
As it was nearly time for Dorothy to dine with Ozma, which she did every evening, she rang for a servant and ordered the Woozy taken to a nice room and given plenty of such food as he liked best.
"That's honeybees," said the Woozy.
"You can't eat honeybees, but you'll be given something just as nice," Dorothy told him. Then she had the Glass Cat taken to another room for the night, and the Patchwork Girl she kept in one of her own rooms, for she was much interested in the strange creature and wanted to talk with her again and try to understand her better.
End of Chapter 16.
Chapter 17 of The Patchwork Girl of Oz by L. Frank Baum. This LibriVox recording is in the public domain. Chapter 17. Ozma and Her Friends. The Shaggy Man had a room of his own in the royal palace, so there he went to change his shaggy suit of clothes for another, just as shaggy, but not so dusty from travel. He selected a costume of pea-green and pink satin and velvet, with embroidered shags on all the edges and iridescent pearls for ornaments. Then he bathed in an alabaster pool and brushed his shaggy hair and whiskers the wrong way to make them still more shaggy. This accomplished, and arrayed in his splendid shaggy garments, he went to Ozma's banquet hall and found the Scarecrow, the Wizard, and Dorothy already assembled there. The Scarecrow had made a quick trip and returned to the Emerald City with his left ear freshly painted.